Hello everyone, this is the fourth episode of my Arduino Basics series. Today we are going to adjust the brightness of an RGB LED with the help of two types of loops and the analog write function. Let's get started. This project will work like this. We are going to initialize three pins for the red, green and blue component of our LED. Then we are going to increment one color's brightness to the maximum value and then decrease to the minimum. We do this for all three components, then repeat. For this project we will need a breadboard, an Arduino, an RGB LED, three 220 ohms resistor, four male-to-male jumper wires, and the USB cable. The only new component is the RGB LED, so let's have a closer look. We can think of this RGB LED as three individual LEDs with different colors in one package. They can either have the same positive side or the same negative side, mine have the same negative side. Always check your datasheet if you are not sure. We can interact with this LED the same way as we did with the simple ones, but now we can also mix the colors. I said we are going to adjust the brightness, but that would require voltages between 5 and 0 volts, right? Our Arduino is a digital device and it cannot produce any analog voltages, but it can imitate them by switching between high and low in a smart way. The idea is this. The signal will be a kind of square wave, and the only thing that changes is that how long we have high value during a period. The ratio of how long the signal was in the high state compared to the complete period is called the duty cycle. So a 50% duty cycle means the signal is in the high state half the time. When we apply this to an LED, our eyes kind of averages out the on and off times, making the LED dimmer. This kind of signal is called pulse width modulated signal, or PWM for short. We can apply this kind of signal from the digital pins, which have the squiggly lines under them. With the Arduino Uno, we can produce PWM signals with 8-bit resolution. This means we can represent 256 different values. Because of this, the analog write function will ask for a value between 0 and 255. Let's connect the circuit. As seen in the schematic, the common negative pin is the second, also the longest, so connect it to ground. The first is the red pin, the third is the green, and the fourth is the blue. Connect all of them to a digital pin which supports PWM in series with a 220 ohms resistor, and we are done. Let's move on to the code. As usual, we start by declaring the variables. We got three pins, red, green and blue. In the void setup, we set them up as outputs. In the void loop, we have the interesting part. Remember, we have 256 different brightness values to choose from because of the resolution. So we want to increase from 0 to 255 and then decrease from 255 to 0 and do this for every color. We will do this with the for loop and with the while loop also. Let's start with the for loop. The for loop needs three inputs. The first input is the looping variable, which is initialized when the looping starts. The second input is a conditional statement. While this expression is true, the code for the for loop keeps getting executed over and over again. But if it evaluates to false, the code breaks out of the loop. The third input is a rule, which says how to change the loop variable after each cycle, making sure that we don't stay in the for loop forever. Okay, so we need a for loop. The first argument to our for loop is an integer brightness starting from 0, because we want the LED to start from the completely off state. The second argument is the condition, we want to stay in the loop while the looping variable is less than 256. The third argument is the rule. We want to increment the looping variable by 5 each cycle. We can apply the PWM signal with the analog write function. The first argument is which pin you want to address, this will be the red pin, and the second is the duty cycle between 0 and 255, for this we will use the looping variable brightness. After this, we want to wait some time with the delay function, 20 milliseconds will do. Now we want to slowly decrease the brightness with another for loop. Now we start the looping variable from 255 and exit the loop when we reach 0, and with every cycle we decrease its value by 5. Everything else is the same. Now we have a red LED with changing brightness. we copy both for loop and make the exact same thing to the green and blue pin, we only have to change the analog write functions. We can upload the code. Now we do the same with the while loop. The while loop takes only one argument, a condition. While that condition is true, the while loop keeps executing its code. This condition will be the same as with the for loop. In the while loop we do the same thing, call the analog write on the red pin first with the brightness variable. We have to initialize that brightness variable at the beginning of the code as an integer starting at 0. Then the same delay, and after that we have to increment the brightness variable, because if we forget to do that, we remain in this loop forever. In the next while loop we are going to decrease the brightness value until we reach 0. We do this two more times for the two other colors. Now we can upload the code. With that, we cover the basics of Arduino programming. Now we can start to use more serious sensors, motors, advanced programming concepts, and much more. If you got interested in doing these projects and want to follow along, I give you links to the kits I use in the description below, so you can have the exact same components I have. If you have any question, observation or feedback, please leave a comment below. Also, if you liked this video, let me know by like, share and subscribe. Thank you and see you in the next episode.